Hello everybody, this is Nilesh from CRM Next and I belong to an engagement services group from CRM Next, and today my topic for my presentation would be enterprise resource planning. So let's start with enterprise resource planning. So avoiding all the technicalities and all the definitions of enterprise resource planning, in a very layman term I can explain it. The definition and the knowledge about enterprise resource planning is in the name itself. It is enterprise resource planning. So the resources which are used in an enterprise at a business level is planned so accurately that the information flow is very clear and the data is very real time. So what is an ERP? So ERP, in a very broader way, in a very bird's eye view, we can say ERP, it integrates and manages all the core parts of the business. So in an enterprise, there are various business. There are n number of business that is happening in an ERP, in an enterprise. So the business which are associated in an enterprise can be of this form. If we can go to the ERP section. So there can be inventory management, there can be accounting, there can be procurement, CRM, sales, payroll, e-commerce, marketing, etc., etc. So these types of business are accommodated in a single enterprise. So information flow between those business is very much essential, and it is very much required for the betterment of the business and for the betterment of the enterprise. So let's take an example. There's a medicine shop in your area. So its first venture, let's say the name of the medicine shop is XYZ. So it starts with a single outlet in your area. So managing that is pretty much easy because it's a single outlet. Vendors come in, give their medicines, distributors and customers comes in and take those medicines based on prescription anyhow. So at the end of the day, what the shopkeeper can do, he can collect all the data. Okay, this much sold, this much is pending, this much medicines has been expired or something on something. So taking that into existence, so that is pretty much very much easy, okay, managing those datas. So let's make it difficult. So the business goes very well, he earns a lot of profit. So he decides to open a second outlet in the nearby area. So what happens? The profit is distributed now. So the profit is doubled as well as distributed, as well as the number of resources to be allocated also doubles. So there are resources at shop number one, there are resources at shop number two who are managing those datas. So let's go beyond it. So there are 10 such outlets at 20 such various places. So now you can imagine how the complexity increases. So what a shopkeeper can do, he can assign a various sales team who can only manage the sales process. He can assign a various procurement team who can only take in the details of medicines. And he can assign a different team who can do the reporting and who can do the inventory stuff. Okay, this is how much profit we earned this today and tomorrow. So, but the issue is, if everything is handled by human are prone to error. So data redundancy is a very complex issue. Plus on human, you have to be dependent upon a particular human that he has to be present on this day or that day, so that the data is very much real time, as well as it is inputted in a very proper way. There should be a backup plan if it is not available. And the third is a cost. We have to pay that guy, and at the end of the day he or she can, like, if the data is very much vast, at the end of the day he or she has to use a particular system to input and gather all the data and present it a very organized and very profitable way, so that a business can make a decision. And decision making is very much difficult in such cases, because at the end of the day, at the end of the month or at the end of the week, you have to be very much clear that what inventory has been sold, what inventory is still in my stock, and what inventory needs to be inputted. So that decision becomes very complex if it is handled in a very manual way. So what ERP does? So let's take an example that medicine shop XYZ has implemented that ERP across all borders. So how the sales and the procurement process becomes very much easy. So this I will highlight to you. So normally in the legacy system, in the manual system, what he or she has to do, he has to check or his or her registers on a daily basis. That what are the things that has to be inputted from the vendor, what are things that I sold to the customer. So let's take an example that I want some XYZ medicines to be bought into my place. So what he can do, he can raise a requisition, a purchase requisition from the system itself. After raising a purchase requisition, he can require for, he can the requisition for a quotation. Like, okay, I have this much requirement of let's say 5 medicines and my quotation is this much. So various vendors can come into picture, and that vendor ABC came into picture. Okay, I will give this much medicines for this much price. I will give this medicine for this much price. So what here the decision making becomes very much easy for the shopkeeper or for an enterprise that okay, I have to buy this this medicine from this much vendor. So this decision making capability is done by the ERP itself. There is no manual intervention on this. So after the quotation is approved, a purchase order has been generated for a particular vendor by the system itself. No human has to come in, tell the vendor, okay, I want this much medicines. So a purchase automatically is being generated. After that, if the item is received, like a particular warehouse comes in and gives the items, the medicines, the item received again is automatically generated by the system itself based on some the criteria if the item is received. So automatically after the item is received, no manual person have to go open his memos and create a bills for it. Automatically a vendor bill or invoice would be automatically generated based on the item received. The best part about here is the accounting thing, account and finance. You don't have to manage the accounts thing that okay, I have given this much to this much vendor. Okay, I have received only 5 out of 5 items. So I don't have to get that data in a separate book on a separate memo. The system itself does the thing for you. So last is the payment method. And the best part about the payment method, when you go to the manual system, you have only one payment method, that is cash. Either you have to go to the third party vendor, or we can integrate various payment method depending on the vendors. So this is the procurement process if I want to order some items at my shop using an ERP. So second is order to cash. When normally what happens in the legacy system, like people come in, people have write, okay, I want this is much medicines. So they write on the book. After being the medicine is being sold, they maintain a separate register. Okay, the XYZ has been decreased by quantity 3 or by quantity 5. So there is all manual work from A to B. So when let me explain order to cash, so that the next process would be easy. So in the legacy system, there is no process of lead identification. Okay, he comes in, then only we can change that lead into a customer or anything. So but in an ERP system, what happens? We have various measures of lead identification through web portal, through marketing strategy. Various marketing strategy can be implied for lead identification. After the lead has been identified, we give the estimate to the lead. Okay, the estimate, okay, if you want 10 medicines, this is the estimate. So if he agrees, like he has, okay, he's ready to see the estimate. So that lead is converted into a prospect. Okay, I'm ready to see the estimate. I want the next thing, what the thing is happening. So there are various negotiations. Okay, I don't want this at this much price. I want this at this much price. So there is an approval for it. When the estimate is signed by the lead becomes an opportunity. And after opportunity, after it has been like opportunity has been identified and the last process is being generated, then that signed estimate is converted into sales order. So normally the sales order is a process where only the sales of a particular item has been identified. So here the customer is identified. Or proper which are the items to be sent to the customer is identified. All the details are here. After that, item fulfillment takes place. Normally at a very small level, enterprise, if I take a shop of medicine shop, the item fulfillment is not a process. That is just a handing over of things. But a very enterprise level value, take the items from a larger geographical area. So there is an item fulfillment process that is being taken place. So in item fulfillment, there is a packing, picking up and shipping of things. So here also, ERP plays a very important role, that from various warehouses picks the information whether my item has been is in which area, what is the arrival time of my item. Accordingly, the item is picked from a warehouse, it is packed a particular place, and accordingly it is shipped. If I am serving from sitting in Mumbai, I am serving some place in Delhi. Let's take an example. After that, automatically as soon as it has been shipped, my item has been shipped, an invoice has been generated based on customer, and again the payment method remains the same. It has a broader prospect of the payment. So in this whole process, the best part about it, you don't have to manage any kind of inventory. The system automatically does it for you. As soon as there is a purchase or there is a sale made, the inventory automatically gets impacted, and the material or the item is being decreased or increased based on the process that is being underlined. So, and the best part about is there is always a real time data. You every time a single sale is, let's take an example, my medicine shop is in 5 different states. So if I want to know a particular medicine named as Crocin, it has, what is the sales of that Crocin in a different state? I have to don't call up, or in a legacy system, don't need to call up and every state give me the report. So at the end of the day, I will give the report. You can just manage the reporting. Let the reporting always, ERP maintains the reporting tool. You have to just go and do the reporting tool, and accordingly, state wise, the details are always mentioned. So the decision making capability is very much easy. Very important part is the real-time data. Information flows across the system, so no user have to manually maintain any kind of data or any kind of input in based on some books, registers, or anything. So let's move to the, so since ERP is a very integrated concept, there are many things, but it also has some disadvantage also. So first we'll list the advantage, then we'll go to disadvantage. So as I said, it is an integrated way. You don't have to manually go in every register or every system to put in the data, then it will integrate the data, then it will send across. As soon as the process happens, it will integrate all the data and will send across all the systems. Since I said it is there is no manual intervention, there is very hard, I can't say there is no manual intervention, there is very less manual intervention, and since it is based on the process and system, so process are it eliminates duplicacy, right? The redundant data is, since humans are very much prone to error, the duplicacy has been eliminated. Third is very efficient. You don't have to wait for the whole day for a single report. It's like a point and click. You just point and click, the report is being generated. Fourth is the streamlined process. Like every process is being streamlined. As soon as a single process is happening, the next process dependent upon it executes, and the data is being updated. The fifth is better analytics. I can say it is better decision making. So based on your sales and procurement reports, you can take better decision. Okay, what next needs to be done in this process? Okay, this medicine is not getting sold everywhere, so I have to stop purchasing this medicine. I have to go for the next medicine. Since manual process always have the registers, papers, everything, so security has been very much difficult in this. So we use servers, clouds for security, even though my system crashes, but my data is always available on the server. Mobility, we can also use that ERP systems through my laptop, mobiles, and everything. And the last is a very important, it's a real-time data. No matter where are you sitting, if I am sitting in Mumbai, if I want to know the sales in Delhi, I don't have to go and call the Delhi guys or any point of contact in Delhi. I can go enter my ERP, log in, and accordingly get the sales sales figure in of Delhi. So, and ERP system are very much efficient in its own way, depending upon the enterprise, but it doesn't mean that it doesn't have disadvantage. Every system is prone to disadvantage. No system is perfect. So what happens in legacy system? The thing is, you just have to maintain registers and papers. That cost is very negligible as compared to the profit they earn. So cost of the system increases. Second is the implementation time. When today I decide, okay, I want to move from legacy to ERP, it is not like that I have system integrated. Tomorrow there are system comes in and I integrate everything. No, it does take time. Normally, I have seen it has taken more than a year for implementation. So that period you have to incur cost as well as business have to suffer. Third is the payback. As soon, it is a human tendency as well as the business thing. As soon as you invest something, you normally expect a payback. So ERP always gives the payback in a period of time. It is not that quick. Like after implement today, I have go live through my ERP. So I can see the advantages and the return of investment after 5 to 6 months, depending upon the amount of data it is handling. Fourth is the indirect cost. Normally, when you switch to systems, there are servers included, there are systems included. There are many much indirect costs that are included. There are routers, there are internet plans that has to be updated everywhere. So that comes into cost. Fifth is then very important is the data migration. So in legacy system, like for 7 years down the line, I'm using a legacy system and I want all the data to be migrated from legacy system to my current system. So that becomes a very much hectic part in data migration because I have to generate some kind of tool so that, or I have to purchase, that also cost has included, I have to purchase a third party which will do the work for me. And fifth is also important, users participation of training. So tomorrow if I tell, okay, I want to use an ERP system, so it depends upon the user who are using the ERP system. So tomorrow if the user is reluctant to use the ERP system, so it won't give you a profit. So you have to train your users. You have to make sure that user participate in every single bit of training that has been given. And user also skilled labor. You can't give a layman a system, okay, come on, you can use it. You always have to use the skill labor. So overall, this was a bird's eye view, or we can say overview of ERP system. ERP is very much deeply integrated in everything. As you can see, it is included in manufacturing. It is also included in e-commerce, payroll, CRM, human resource. So I have given you the sales and the procurement cycle of ERP. So this much is it. Thank you. Thank you.